unfortunately, it's not working. Well, you can watch episodes, they are in YouTube, so you can check the series. Just type My Little Pony, which is magic, and you can find all the episodes. Hasbro hasn't been taking an aggressive stance against copyright infringement. In fact, they are very, they embrace this kind of free advertising. So this is one of the reasons why the internet community has got the pony fever so well. Other viewers and internet followers, why they watch this cartoon? I tried to pinpoint some characteristics from this group. Well, first, we have the target audience parents. Of course, they are going to watch what their kids are watching in the television. Next, animation and fantasy fans who were very interested when they would hear the name of Lauren Faust attached to this project. Of course, Lauren Faust, and your point was a low value cartoon with a high profile producer and animator. It was interesting. 80s and 90s kids. That's people who grown in Saturday mornings watching cartoons. So they are probably in their 20s, 30s, 40s probably. So there is a nostalgia factor also. People with strong online social interaction, that is, for example, me, I was introduced to the series by an online friend. She lives in the United States, and she was talking. It was random, and I simply followed her links, and that was it. The new sincerity movement, who is opposed to cynicism, it's a new way to watch TV. It's very recent. It's the contrary of the postmodern habit. Watch things for the irony factor. I watch it because it's lame. In this case, it's, the life of the show is very sincere. The people is really liking the show. It's really following the message. Positive and it even has influence, the influence has been positive to their lives. And the remix and remix culture. Remix culture is about mixing elements from one thing to another. For example, there have been mixes of pony imagery with movie trailers. The most impactant case has been the company Hub. They acquired some rights to Katy Perry's song, California Girls, and they remixed it to a new song. They're called Equestria Girls, and it's really hilarious. And memetic culture is, well, it's based on memes. It's a meme is an idea, behavior, or style that switches from person to person within a culture. So we have lots of ideas, crazy ideas, and where they start to repeat, they pick interest across the online culture. Many are inside jokes, many are likely they are too easy to understand, but some others they are author preference. And well, online has had a big impact, but in the real world there hasn't been a big impact in the case of
merchandise. Hasbro is still marketing toys. Well, it's their objective. But a lot of fans feel that there is a huge niche market in the in this area. One of the first companies that launched products, presented products, was a website t-shirt manufacturer, Wheel of Pine, and they had they launched two contests. They are already two contests. And the, for example, this was this one was one of the winning contests. I took me that one of mine. This one. And they awarded the monetary prize for the second round is 7 euros. It's 3 times euros. I think it's $100. Well, this fandom is really rich with creativity. It's teeming with so the probability of getting a good idea and a very colorful one is very high, and it has lasted more than 1 year and it's still ongoing, so it's not a fad. It's not something that it's, it has just come and it's going to leave just like it came. So, well, I think it is very interesting. It was not expected that a show for little girls and boys was going to have this impact. So, yes, online and people's life. So, that's all. If you have any questions, thank you.
I didn't understand the relation that you have with that cartoon.
Ah, well, myself, I'm a fan of the cartoon. So, one of the things that attracted me to the cartoon was the quality of the animation. It's very expressive. It's a shame that we couldn't see a small sample, because you can hear a very fluid animation. It's flash, but it's not the lazy flash that you are used to see. It has effects, and it's reinforced with a voice acting that is very powerful. It's very emotional. At least in the English version, it is very very good. The Spanish version that it premiered on this Monday, so it was good. Yeah, I didn't miss it. It was okay. It was an okay job. I think that maybe in some months after it starts to pick up, or an open channel, an open broadcast channel, picks the series, it's going to ramp up in popularity. At the same level or even more than Power of Kids. Some people even say that it's the new SpongeBob for fans.
So this cartoon is only online?
It's in the cable television channel, and it's only available in United States and in Canada. It's a pay per view channel, so it has a small audience. But thanks to the internet, the audience has been increased largely by millions. So why Hasbro and Hub hasn't been taken down the channels, the videos on YouTube. Yes. Maybe when they start selling DVDs or Blu-rays, legal ways for people to acquire the series, perhaps they want to start to take down the videos.
You mentioned something about a meme, but I didn't understand because I have read and see some memes that are like very simple drawings and with different expressions are hilarious, but most of them are like rude
or creepy or
sexual.
That's the adult aspect that has been included in the series. For example, the troll.
Yes.
Yes.
Or forever, no?
Forever.
Her face.
Yes. Or Nyanka. You have heard that about that. You have seen Nyanka. It's a cat, it's flying, it's squirting a rainbow, and full rainbow that has a rainbow, so there they dressed her as a Nyanka, but she is an adult. But for example, Celestia, it's because she sometimes is playful. She sometimes is pranked or acts in a way that couldn't have caused many problems, but at the end it causes